comps aren't that big. I think it's just a nice rainer that we somehow missed. This one just to our west-north, I guess. And this one just to our east. Lovely. It's starting to rain. I just realized that. See how big these drops are. 100% see drops falling. It's just a matter of if they're gonna hit the rock or not. But is that a rainbow? It's a rainbow forming right down. No, we just get the clip end of it, so it's not happening. Yeah, there it is. There's a drop. The tiny little piece of crap. Nice cells along down here. Got a rainbow down there. See if it's visible over here. Nope, it's down there. Very few drops coming now. Like literally drip drops. Not even much. Ooh. Decent sized drops. Meh. Anything? Nothing else other than that, though. Just little drip drops of decent sized drops. Big whoop. Well, I'm gonna go check the radar and see how things are going. I highly expect more cells coming in later in the evening hours. A little bit more of a prime time for those more prominent ones. Wowzers. Nice low rainbow. God, the air smells so much fresher. That's a little bit of humidity to the dry day. Nothing above us, but that doesn't mean anything. Not much, but there is those coming up from the Soyuz region. I'll be making their way up there as the day progresses. The recent weather network update has maintained the threat for this evening and maintained the level 6 be prepared risk for tomorrow. The only thing they actually have changed is extending the threat from just till just 9 to now from basically now till 8 instead of just 9. So we got that. Yeah. Can't feel it. Yeah. That's it. Just a little bit of a quick shower. Quick shower, and then that's it. It's nice. It's just a little bit of a shower in. Freshens the air just a little bit. Yeah. Well, we'll see how the rest of today goes. So I would definitely say later in the evening around 7. I would definitely say that's around prime time. Here's the weather next forecast. Actually goes to 9 p.m. I guess they updated it to go an extra hour longer. And radar, new updated one, doesn't intensify the storm too much, but you can see a few cells down here are starting to pick up intensity as well. So it's not what I was expecting, but I'll take it. These will mainly miss. This right here, I guess. Well, maybe these might skim by, like the one we just had. This one here. But that'll be at best. But here's 3 radar loops, and then see you guys whenever later on. Drops the game big. The one thing about light rain, it doesn't cool anything down, it just humidifies the air, makes it hot. Cool little shower over here. Cool. Typical summer shit. To dry on the surface and not much rain couldn't actually reach the surface, the heaviest stays above. Get some proper photos and maybe even time lapse of this later on. Gotta do other things though. It's cool though. Do a 30-second loop, then I'll show you guys the emergency update environment kind of made. 6:30, I believe. Yeah, some thunderstorm threat. I was only meant to go in this southeast corridor here, and nowhere near here. great threat map by Environment Canada. Can really see why they're undermining tomorrow's threat. Here's the new update. All they did was just upgrade to a 30% chance of showers there this evening and risk of a thunderstorm. It's kind of late now. It's not there anymore. And there's your tomorrow set. Starts at 2 p.m. and onward. Yep. That's how it's looking. The new National Weather Service, or Special Storm Prediction Center, has a moderate risk that extends barely into our region near here. It's just for wind though. So it's a 5% wind threat. Though obviously conditions could be different from even from here to up there. This conditions could be different. But oh yeah, there we go. That's the sign. Oh, I saw the sign. That this could be a severe threat. So I'm getting ready for it. Hoping tomorrow we can pull off our 8th severe threat of the year. I'll see you guys tomorrow. Well, here we are. Today they don't have the map out just yet. But as you can tell, I got a feeling it's going to be mainly the eastern side here that will be under the severe potential. We are situated, I cannot actually tell by this horrible map. We're here somewhere. And here somewhere where all those showers are. But obviously things can change because this was issued at 4 a.m. in the morning. Things can change as it is 8 a.m. Models change. But obviously conditions ripen for this development of numerous showers and thunderstorms caused by this beauty right here. And if we check the synopsis, they say this, for numerous communities in the eastern half of the province, like I said, and sustaining thunderstorms overnight and evolving to a band of heavy showers and thunderstorms on Wednesday from the northeast. Widespread thunderstorm activity for the interior was scared, with severe storms possible for numerous communities in the eastern half of the province. Obviously, this could have changed. But, anyways, we're now back at the level 6 be prepared risk for today. Slightly lowered here, but it's heightened a bit. It stayed around the same here. I mean, that's a good sign, though. They're still confident we're going to get something. Weather isn't too much. They haven't changed theirs since last night. Well, I guess earlier in the night. And then the weather network is now 60% chance, and then they have upgraded it to a risk of thunderstorms this evening. They've gone to do this, so 60% chance starting at 2 and you have 5, and then again showers with the risk of thunderstorms starting at 8 and you have 10, 80%. I do personally believe this chance will probably last longer. Because lots of models to say nighttime shit seems prime. But either way, that's how it's looking. I'll be back with the outlook. And or possibly the 11 a.m. update as well. Depending on when they pulled out the outlook. I do genuinely expect that so to be probably on the edge of the severe threat. Or the moderate risk area. I do definitely expect a moderate risk for us. But I don't know about the severe threat. We may be just on the edge of it, enough for us to get a severe watch, but it's looking like we may just be just a tad off. But I think the moderate risk will be enough to give us a watch. We'll see. See you guys later. So they have still at the, it's 11 o'clock, they still don't have their outlook out. They don't have any watches out anywhere in BC right now. They're being really lazy and late with this. Unless there's just no risk anymore, but we have showers of thunderstorms possibility today, and then a few showers of thunderstorms ending late this evening. Here's the catch, though. This is how it's going to go. 80% from 11 till 5. And then 100% chance from 6 to 10. A little break, and then we'll be right back at it from 12 to 5 a.m. So all day we have a solid, like literally all day we have a solid threat of storms into early tomorrow morning, basically. Unbelievable. I swear I just heard some thunder outside right now. I'm not 100% sure, but we got these storms over here coming up. It's like a training line in them, making their way up. There you can see definitely some storms going down there as well. But yeah, I'll be back as soon as the outlook comes out. I'll definitely show you guys the outlook as soon as it comes out, but Jesus Christ, they're very, 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 very late with this. It's the worst they've ever done, I'm not gonna lie. Least reliable, I should say. Meter's not half bad. We got a new little embedded cell developing down here. This is starting to intensify a little bit. It's not looking too bad. They have issued watches, but it's only for one area of, like, multiple, like, half a dozen or more regions right now. But, either way, we're about to get rammed in with some showers. I'm just gonna go to the bathroom and I'll be showing you guys how it looks outside. Hopefully they outlook sometime in soon. It's clearly only one region getting a severe thunderstorm watch, which is in northeastern BC with this watch. There is something that has significantly changed. It has started raining. Decent drop size. They're getting to a worrying. It's definitely. Should probably finish my thought. A worrying definite size of drops that would be associated with a decent hailer. But they have gotten smaller. But yeah, this weekend. It's just something working down there. This thing's been weakening fairly decently. No lightning out of it, but storm coming in from the southwest once again has increased, has strengthened a decent sum. We should definitely get something out of that one, depending on how it rolls its way here. No pun intended. I'm still waiting on the outlook, unless it's out now. Still waiting on the watches, if they're even going to get issued. It's getting a little bit heavier. Yeah, I'm gonna go see if the new radar update and outlook is up. See if those are out or not. God, this looks rushed, because look at the thunderstorm icon here. Look at the split here, 80k, 1.5. It's the same thing. They're just rushing it. And then look at this. Oh, this is more working. And then this is their thunderstorm, this is their hail threat. It's a thunderstorm icon. They obviously rushed it a little bit. But either way, we're in a moderate risk for fairly strong wind gusts, almost very strong wind gusts. And decent sized hail, 1 centimeter up to maybe just above 1/2 inch. That's decent sized. I'd say that's about nickel sized. I'd say dime sized. Dime sized sounds more appropriate. But yeah, it's actually pretty good. Pretty good update. Got plenty of the 50mm thing's gone here now. We're right in the moderate risk for 80Ks and 1 to 1.5 centimeter sized hail. 0.4 to, I believe, 0.4 to 1/2 inch sized hail. Pretty good. And 80Ks are probably about 50 to 60 miles per hour. I think they may issue a watch if it's warranted throughout the day. Yeah, I'm asking, though, what the difference is between the two, or if it's just an outlook error like this is. But yeah. See if further watches get issued today. If not, that'll be alright. We're still in a decent, strong storm potential. Solid. Storms have been since on a weakening trend now. Looks like we have to wait a little bit longer for those storms. Oh, it's sunny. No, it can be fitted in. But yeah. We'll see. So they have this out now, but I'm mainly just showing it for the discussion here they have. While the southeast has a delayed start, so most of this good stuff will be starting up in the evening hours, kind of when they're suggesting around 6 o'clock, the late afternoon, early evening hours. Obviously, still bring that chance during the afternoon, but not as significant. Though they have not said why this is like separated. Unless it's just different timings, like this is going to be the delay, this is going to be the definite. I don't know.
I'm not, it doesn't say. What, the southeast? This is like the southeast right here. So, I don't know. It doesn't make any sense. They would obviously say a difference. Because the southeast could mean anything. But still though, underestimated of storms, 80 km, 1 to 1.5 sized hail. Probably a late start today, though, so that continues throughout much of the day. Threat is throughout much of the day, but the more significant stuff starts in the evening, late afternoon, early evening. Late afternoon, evening hours. And yeah. We'll see. We'll see how it plays out, see if I get any replies from Environment Canada suggesting why they have this split up, or why they don't have a watch out. And yeah. Alright, so looking storm down here. We're all with a flat ass shelfie trying to go here. Nice clouds. It's like smooth looking little things. Huh. No reply still from EC. EC, doubt they'll reply. Dear. Just about the questions, if they're going to actually watch us without BC, if they're going to watch throughout the day, just keep a heads up on it, and the difference between the two risks. The one centralized on us, one section just for us, and then the little bit farther north, and then the other one. For the Kootenays. Kootenays.
You don't like it yet, so
this is a really good looking shower.
Well, not much has happened, but get ready to look at that storm. It went from nothing, like from a shower to that, and then went up right to that. Maxed out DBZ, and then it just slowly started weakening. Look how it turns into. It just falls apart within from 12:10 by 12:50. Just fell apart into nothing. Probably only maintained that intensity for like not even a quarter of its life. But nothing else going, just like they said, the evening's gonna probably be prime time. Sun's gonna start coming out in a moment. We should start seeing at least some kind of daytime heating in a moment. As soon as this passes through, we should see some development start up. This isn't completely accurate, and I won't lie, this is a very guilty pleasure of mine to check radar composite. But this is how it is. At 4 o'clock, we're starting to see significant development, possibly. Pretty far from us, into our southwest. Mind you, taking consideration, storm direction could be very different to what's shown on here. Intensity can be different as well. And yeah, look at that. And then at 5 o'clock, we got this going on here, cells going up, all that goodies, and then it just kind of falls apart, and then we got this goes ape shit up here. But then not much else happens after. There's 8 o'clock, you know, maybe a little pocket cell comes through. Maybe a couple pocket cells. But nothing significant. And then that just skims by. And then at 18Z, the 18Z run was completely different. Completely different story. It had nothing going on at 4. There's 5. Maybe a little pocket cell. That goes up. 6. Started to see some more. 7.
See, starts seeing some pocket cells starting to go here. 8. Decent storm development going on right here. Look at that. And 9. Multicellular situation. I did some precise checking. I got a ruler here. With Google Maps. And this. Side by side. And I have determined these could either slice or just barely near our area. Like, basically, it rides just over the ridges, basically. It gets as close as to skimming our actual downtown area. No, as far, it'll be as far away as just sitting on top of the ridges and as close as hitting, slicing downtown. Not with the core part, though, with, like, the reddish part, orange-reddish part that's really hard to see. And these black lines suggest updrafts. So these could have some significant hail on them as well. But as I have said, this is a radar composite. This is not reliable. This is just an idea. It does not do localized stuff, so there could be a lot more development than what's suggested. Here's the instability from the 18Z. And you can see, lots of instability comes into play in the nighttime hours, and as you can tell, there's lots of instability, but as you can tell, no development happens here. So there's obviously a lot more at stake than just those cells. There could be a lot more localized development. And then NAMNES is eh, but it's still alright. I'll be checking Euro at 4 o'clock just to be sure, but I can tell you right now, it's gonna be close. It's gonna be close today. I'll be definitely watching as the day goes forward. Watch is possibly getting issued, definitely for strong wind gusts, maybe hail, and definitely heavy rainfall. But I don't know. The chances are starting to look very slim, but H-Triple has always been leading off of today getting any nighttime storms, so. And Euro has been consistent, like consistent since Sunday. So, I don't know. And NAMNES has kind of been flipping back and forth each run, basically. But it's been slowly starting to downtrend more for the nighttime hours. But it's still doing pretty good. It's still doing something that I will accept. But it seems like it's going to be the roll of the dice. It's going to be really close. It's going to depend on when this upper level trough starts moving in. It's going to depend on where it's positioned. I'll see you guys when it's needed. Here it is. They have upgraded today to an 80% chance for the evening hours and an 80% chance for the overnight hours. Here's go. And then the hourly suggests some 4 p.m. storms, possibly 40%. And then 80% for the evening hours from 8 to 11. Starts off at 60, goes down to 40, goes back up to 70, 80. And overnight it goes to 12 a.m. only, but still an 80% chance. Still pretty decent enough. It's the highest probabilities the weather network has had for this threat, so this is pretty good looking. And yeah, that's all I had to show.
Build up starting to really become noticeable now. Cumulus is starting to rise pretty quickly. Cumulus is all over the place now. Cells are actually starting to pop to ourselves. I would not be surprised. Storm development starts up at around 5. The more widespread stuff. It's definitely becoming noticeable. No, it's not really been that robust yet. It's not expected to throw this evening. Not even the Kootenays are doing well right now, and that area was under a severe threat earlier. So, we still have plenty of time. Plenty of time. Instability has risen here to 1,000 to 1,500. Naps rates have also increased to around 8
here, around 8, 8.5 even, in the low levels, 2 degrees Celsius per kilometer. And the shear has relatively stayed the same. If anything, the effective has weakened a little bit, but it's so minimal, it's not really that big of a deal. 6 kilometers still relatively the same. And if anything, it's actually just slightly increased more to our west, east. But yeah, it is currently around 3:40 p.m. 4 p.m. update is ready to come out in the next 10 to 20 minutes. Sometimes they pull it out early. This is going to be the big update. This is going to determine it. You're looking forward to it until the time comes, and then if it's good or not. I mean, the Weather Network upgrading theirs to an 80% and all that makes it worthwhile to see what environment Canada is. 4 p.m. came out and zero has changed. They maintain everything. No rainfall totals added, just a few showers of thunderstorms, 100% chance. Stays for the 6 to 10 p.m. and it stays for the 12 a.m. to 5 a.m. for the 60%. Pretty solid. I'll take this. You know what? I'll take the same over worse. Better would give too much hope, less would give less hope, and maintaining it just keeps the cycle. Cells are starting to fire down here, not too much yet even here. Like it says, most of the stuff will be evening stuff, so we're watching 6 o'clock in 2 hours. We should start seeing some significant development. Here we go already. It is currently 5 o'clock, 4 a.m. Development is starting to become noticeable. Right here and right here. Should start seeing some moderate risk criteria storms momentarily. That was actually just something wispy hanging around, but you know, this storm down here has gotten a little bit more oomph to it. See towering down up there. It's moved. See how the convection looks over here. Here it is right here. The storm. Could be a different storm, or it could be the storm house that's down near Penticton and all that, which is pretty far south. So, that's what's happening. Ooh, there's a little bit of a pileus right down there. Sign that is the cap. There is still a cap in place. It's breaking through it. You can see its nose a little poking out of it. Let me get a photo of that. We have a pileus cap right there. He's all busting through it, I guess. It's time. 2 separate areas, actually. One right here, one right here. 2 different separated cells, basically. I'm not gonna watch the Easter lightning since daytime, sun shining right against it. It's not gonna be very clear to see the lightning. Yeah, nice little pileus cap right there. Looking mighty fine. Seriously significant development to my east here. Right there. As the storms have been talking about, that exploded fairly quickly within, I'm going to say, from 4 to 4:20, so probably like 20, 30 minutes. That blew up fairly quickly. No lightning detected though, so it's mainly probably just a very heavy rainfall, probably hail as well. Speaking of caps, look at this. They're everywhere. There's one right here. God. Everywhere. Here's a shower down here.
Look how I shower despite how it looks. God, why is with so many Pileus's cap calls today? It's gotta be the big cap with the massive instability today. Jesus. One of the most well-developed and closest Pileus's I've seen. Jesus Christ. Ghost right above there. It's cool. So that's what's keeping most of these storms down clear is the cap. Anything that's over, like, not over the mountains, seems like it develops a massive-ass cap on it. And anything on the mountains just does its own thing. So that cell is probably just off from the mountains, the tops. So that's probably why most of its ability, storm development's pretty substandard right now. I mean, they say 6 o'clock, 100%, they've kept it. Excuse me, Jesus. So, yeah. Guess that's how it's gonna go. So we just wait for that cap to break. And each trip war continues to hype it, and my guilty pleasure continues to ripen as well. It says storm development starts becoming noticeable at 6 o'clock. It's currently 4:55. And then you start seeing some... These are UD updrafts, so they're just significant updrafts, possible rotation. They're fairly unlikely to do any kinds of rotation, so just kind of just ignore them. But that could mean significant storms. And then watch this down here. That starts coming up, and bang, look at that. It says it comes like this as a... it's basically going to be a shelf cloud situation here. This will be at 5Z, so this is 10 o'clock. This will be certainly something significant. UD updrafts right on us as well, so this means there could be in-between significant development. I do have to say this definitely looks like a classical, like, mini MCS situation, because as it continues to go up, it just... maintains this UD updraft. That could be something big. 23Z is currently running right now. And if I can show you guys this updraft velocity. Nope, there we go. There it is, right there. That's the whole entire storm right there. Just makes a whole track. That is something very significant, and that'll be very well watched after, like, 8 o'clock. After 8 o'clock, that'll be definitely watched. After 7. That's pretty significant. These storms, I am going to be watching this very significantly. At 7 to 8. This is looking really... oh, wait. Oh no, my bad. This is 6. Yeah, 6. Okay, there. Yeah, never mind. But wow. That is one of the most impressive model runs I've had from Age Tripwire so far. Here's Namnest version. Comes in a little bit earlier basically. But a lot weaker though. But trends will be monitored. Trends will be monitored. There we go, 6 o'clock, second frame's loaded, and 6 o'clock right here. Lots of cell development. That's always a good sign. We'll see. This is looking pretty mighty spicy. Ho ho ho. Sounding as well. This is basically like a British Columbian version of a loaded gun sounding. As soon as that cap breaks, if it has the chance, this is going to go apeshit. Any word breaks, it's going to go apeshit. The LI, the lifted index, the cape, the PY, that's asking for some decent, strong wing gusts. Sin, that's a significant cap. knows the difference, though. I don't know what the difference is. I think this is the actual station. And this is, like, the GOES. It's, like, basically a model current. It's currently a model. It's a current modeled sounding, I guess. And then this is the actual this is the actual sounding from the site. And then the lapse rates right here, they're not half bad. I mean, I don't know if this rounds it, but if it rounds it, it's I think it's around 7, 7.5. It's below 7.5. It's like 6.5 to 7.5. 7.4, my bad. But yeah, this is looking pretty good.
Cells are going ape shit now. Wait for the 8 o'clock up. I mean the 5:18 update. I'm going to say this right now. If there's not a good storm going by near here by 7 o'clock, the latest, I'm going to be very, very mad. Despite the threat lasting till 10. With this kind of development, I would expect at least something going on more down here as well. New updates out. Jesus Christ. Jesus Christ. The fucking development today. It's on steroids. Jesus Christ. Loop through this 5 times and then I gotta go. Jesus Christ. One more. Well, that escalated very quickly. Look at all these fairly strong cells. Oh, so this is what I'm seeing. Two things. The radars down in the U.S. are picking up a very faint, like, stratiform line that is starting to push these storms down there, northeast, like, straight up northeast. So I would presume that would start reaching here shortly. See some strong storm development. Still no watch as surprisingly, not even any warnings. I would expect they'd reach at least a couple watches, but either way, 22Z showed you guys that line of storms that'd be making its way here for the mid-late evening hours. Early mid-evening hours. That is still showing on a 23Z run, and OOZ is just starting to come out now. So if that's consistent with the OOZ run, I think it's in the bag. We'll see, though. Now, I presume it will be coming from a disconnected line that will be down here pushing up with the upper-level trough that will be pushing storms straight up like this. These may impact depending on timing. But right now, I do definitely expect some kind of watch to be issued, but the later in the day it comes, the least likely it gets. So we kind of just got screwed out of a watch. This would have been more than appropriate. Even if nothing hit, this would have been inappropriate, but yeah. Sorry for the gibberish. Just trying to get this done quickly and not use up so much footage. But yeah, we got this nice line right here. Waiting for the perfect storm. We'll see what ends up happening throughout the day. I do definitely expect evening storms either way. It is 6 o'clock now, so if I don't see any decent storm development by 7, there will be hell raised. There you guys go. I give up. It's 7:30 and there's nothing going. I don't think we're going to get anything. Oh. all day for one storm and we didn't even get one. It's over.
Everything from Namnest. Well, models, so this is Namnest. Maybe some scattered cells try to push their way in near here. It's a 600-700 mine. It's wrong already. But then they say a bunch of scattered shit forms and actually gets pretty intense at 3 a.m. in the morning tomorrow and moves there. But these guys push the line more down here. Here's HRRR 01Z. There's no point showing OZ now. So it has this line still pushing up, but it's still there, but we're kind of like on this kink in the middle here, but it's still a decent intensity. That still comes through. They have nothing for 10Z, surprisingly enough, so this comes through a little bit later. This is 9. They say it. Oh wow, yeah, let me see. Yeah, 8 o'clock, stuff starts getting a little bit interesting. And then 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. So around 11 o'clock, we should start seeing the storm arrive. 9 months tomorrow. So yeah, I'm waiting for 9 o'clock. Put me on my misery. 8 to 9 o'clock, we should start seeing some stuff. Yeah, I'm like 8 to 10 o'clock, we should start seeing some stuff. And then we'll see if anything hits. Yeah.
Oh my precious, we are under our 8th watch of the year. Severe Thunderstorm Watch was issued just moments ago. Oh my god, risk of severe thunderstorms this evening. Oh, they dropped it to a 60%. Nice. 60%. Wait, what? Oh, till 10 p.m. They say, no. That kind of doesn't correlate with this. Here's the watch that was issued. Favorable severe thunderstorms that may be capable of producing strong wind gusts and large hail this evening and overnight. Overnight. So that evening shit is, to me, wrong, but yeah. We got that on our hands. Severe thunderstorm watch has been issued for the evening, possibly into the overnight hours. And much of BC is under a eastern quarter of BC is under a watch right now. Oh my god, this is ridiculous. And the models kind of agree with at least some kind of strong stuff happening, so there you guys go. Under our 8th watch of the year, risk of severe thunderstorms this evening. Probably till 10 o'clock, but I would definitely watch the overnight hours for maybe some severe stuff as well for heavy rainfall and strong wind gusts. Maybe some small hail. But I typically don't hear of large hail possible at 10 o'clock at night. The latest I've had large hail. Latest I've had hail was like 9 o'clock at night. So maybe we can get it at 10. I don't know. We'll see how things trend. Radar right now isn't too impressive. So I've been watching this, so I was trying to actually disconnect from the line. It's been trying to go northeast this whole entire time, so maybe, I don't know, it's weird. But yeah, there we go. Our 8th watch of the year. Thankfully, they changed it back to a 60% because I can tell you right now it's not a definite shot, but it's a shot. I'll show you guys a 15-second loop of the radar. My bad, 30 seconds. That has to be coming this way. That's coming this way, that's going to be a dead-on hit. Storms are starting to turn. They're starting to turn this way. You see this all here starting to turn this way. That's a good sign. That may mean these are starting to move as well northeast. Trends will be monitored.
Now they've gone from they went from a level 2 to a level 5 be prepared risk. That's another big upgrade from earlier today, which they downgraded to a mere level 2. They went right back up to a level 5, presuming that nighttime development is going to be pretty prominent. Notice how it kind of goes like this, so we may just get a skim edge, but like I said, trends are being monitored right now. This is going to be a big day. Well, big night. Hopefully we can get some nighttime lightning, not nighttime light show. Look at this. This is basically a be alert, like level 10 thing. This is going to be big. We're going to keep this on. We're going to keep watching this. I'm going to keep watching this. This is going to be big, possibly.
Nice rain above us right now. Decent sized drops on it. Just been staring at the radar. Well, I've just been waiting on the radar. There's a little bit of glimmer that these storms are slowly starting to push it more and more to the west, east, I mean. A little bit of glimmer. But not really the biggest of hopes yet. New model runs are pretty sad. The H4R ones. Imagine they've been crap all day, so I don't really care about them. It's just kind of just a wish cast and hope. So, yeah. Well, there's a few newly developed connection to these storms down here, just across the board coming this way. Possibly, they're starting to look like anything but. It looks like anything south of the border is going to start more going like this than this. Looks like there's slowly more and more cloud cover here and more development, so there's also that. But not much right now. It's just a waiting game. Like I said, around 9, 10 o'clock, my hope will be given up if nothing's happened. But, I mean, I don't know. We'll see. Sucks. Radar, this is a newly severe warning storm down here. But this is the news story. We got this going up on here. But the third news story, I guess, this right here. So it looks like it wants to just turn and hit us. You can see all these showers down here. Well, showers from this, from here to there, that's like over 100 kilometers. New cells and stuff going. Here's your warnings. We got severe thunderstorm warning in the central interior. We got one in the, I guess you could consider the central Kootenays. These warnings are for, I believe this one is for the highway. This one's for the highway as well. Most of these are just for the highways. This is the actual area. Now it's the waiting game. We'll see what ends up happening. Over 9 hours as well, so this stuff, it could be possibly severe as well. We'll see what ends up happening. Keeping Twitter open for the warnings being issued. Radar and weather, just everything open. Lightning, everything. Keeping on the eyes, see if we get anything. Really on unease with this. So, This is how it's looking. I'm not 100% sure on direction. It looks like it was moving north before. And it looks like it still is. But I can't tell. It definitely looks like it's moving north, though. Not 100% sure. This is what I was looking at here. How I'm telling this is by looking at that cell. It's moving straight north despite this. And I'm looking at this little hookish thing here. Oh no, this is very fishy looking. So this is moving consistently north. While this, it looks like it's moving northeast. I don't know if it's gonna hook its, I think it's, I know what this is going to do. It's gonna hook its way up. It's gonna hook like that. I'm not 100% sure. This is how the radar is looking on here, 10:09. And as I'm going to show you guys real quickly here. Actually, you know what? Let's do it a different way here. This is easier. Yeah, that's, guess that's how it's going to work. So let me just fix this real quick. Fix the lighting for you guys. See what ends up happening. The wait is on. Okay, new lightning detections completely off-centered from these storms. We got these here. These will, if the storms are like at you right there, this will hit, and we got new development here. New radar update. Wow. I don't know why there's been lightning detections. I guess we'll see. Lightning. Oh no. Thunder. I just heard thunder. Thunder from these here. Oh shit. I'm gonna head out. Cause either way though, I was centered right here somewhere, so. There's one detected down here though, so I don't know what that was all about. Maybe we'll check that. I don't know. I'm gonna go head out. It's only 10:30, so running up and down this, well, heading up and down the stairs occasionally will be alright. It's only 10:30. We're gonna head out just to see how this is looking. I'm gonna get a shirt on and all that.